Tertiary calendar is yearly celebrated. Continually, give a pride a place to our history, culture, and tradition as a people. Celebration of this triumph of our collective resistance as a people every year provide an ample opportunity to all our sons and daughters, both at home and in the diaspora, to come together, appreciate God, pray for continuous peace and progress in the coming year. Prince Ogun, a prominent prince of the House of Ludua, born and bred in the palace of Ilefe, where on account of his rhetorical skill, became remarkable among his peers, who nicknamed him Elemi. His title of Elemi was strongly associated with the saga of Prince Odede, alias Oromia, in the dated to 1200 AD. He earned the nickname Elemi or Elemi from his brother Princess and Oduduwa, their father. Elemi subsequently became his title and a trench title of his subsequent successors. He was the father of Elemi Oduaro, who succeeded him in the family, and the third Elemi Awamaro, who established Shadow Kingdom by the conquest of Elemi, the captation of Elemi, and the appropriation of his territories in early 1300 AD. Through this festivity, we constantly celebrate our ancient past and showcase the rich cultural heritage of Ado-Ekiti. The way that gives currency to the past and precisely sustain the present for productive future. Country neighborhoods, the Uroko Festival is a cultural celebration that showcases the historical, cultural, traditional welfare of Ado people as a collective entity. State governments, governors, from other states, government officials, Ado sons and daughters and their friends always play the occasion every year. This introduction is done in order to enhance the collective emphasis on the critical areas of the festival and the yearly celebrations, which consider necessary for the global construction and understanding of our much cherished historical, cultural, and traditional values. The essence of the building in Uroko. This media world press conference, taking place here in Lagos, and the 2019 celebrations of the Uroko Festival, has been lightly prepared by the sole aim of clearly putting across to the people all over the world the reason of the Uroko Festival and to showcase our cultural heritage. It is a very clear, it is very clear in terms of manifestation to further through a more micro study that put the Uroko Festival in a global platform in order to better for usefulness to the cultural being of our Ado-Ekiti people. This assertion is better put into perspective under or reinforced by the following issues. One, through this conference, the attitude of the people both at local and international levels will be further and better educated on the nitty-gritty of the Uroko Festival and CRS celebrations, both of which are deep-seated in history. This is so in that the history of the festival and the CRS celebrations as old as that of Ado Kingdom, which may not be quite known by most people, thereby leading to possible confusion and misinterpretations on what the festival and the celebrations stand for. This claim is demonstrated by the obvious lack of understanding of what Uroko means and is possible for lectures to debate with issues that are far from historical significance. This World Press Conference will clearly avail the opportunity to highlight as we have previously done in the past. The true meaning and manifest function of Uroko to the Ado-Ekiti people as a collective. It will also meaningfully assist the understanding of its transformation into the yearly program. the word Udiroko and its significance to Ado-Ekiti people. Udiroko is a fitting reflection of the significance of the first meeting of Ado-Ekiti under the Uroko tree to celebrate the third founding of Ado Kingdom under the paramount seal of the week, who thereafter for consequence gave a royal proclamation of the first gathering under the Iroko tree on the first day in the adopted Canada year. The commemoration of this first meeting under the Iroko tree with that symmetrically developed into the Iroko as is known and celebrated today. During the first meeting under the Iroko tree, it was decided that such a gathering shall continue to be held at the same time of period every year. This decision was made with the approval of the week because of the significance of the meeting to the people and its enactment of the opportunity for the yearly appraisal of the events of the previous year and the determination of what to do in the next year. The Iroko Festival in Ado is the annual day celebration of Ado Kingdom. So we will be surprised on the 20th of August that we will hear people say Happy New Year, all over the place. Originally, a week was not only a king, he was also the supreme leader of his army. When his kingdom became a little larger than the original settlement of Ado, the administrative and cultural demands of his office as a paramount ruler did not allow him to go on vicious position anymore. He therefore delegated his military responsibilities to his immediate senior officers of the kingdom's army, who were expected to annually render the account of their world's effort on the Iroko Day, which was the fourth day in the traditional calendar. The indigenous population of Ado made offerings of gold and nuts and were not in preparation to that end. This is known as Olorunborun. Thereafter, they will assemble under the Iroko tree in the witch palace to welcome the military officers and all other sons and daughters and to rejoice with the week. The same way, the war chiefs served their people with fools and drinks, were not and could not are generally served to people. Senior army officers and warlords at that time later became traditional watches. Consequent upon this, it was compulsory for them to render the accounts of their stewardship for the year during the Uroko Day that continued to mark the first meeting of all other divisions under the Uroko tree, which they will following the establishment of the kingdom. From then on and up to this day, the Uroko Festival became a yearly commemorative day for the first assembly of the people under the Iroko tree, which is the paramount ruler of the week. This was as a result of the wish resolve to keep and immortalize the first traditional assemblage of his people under the Olorunborun day. It was the duty of each war chief to regularly report his military achievements on the week. The arrival of his successful war chiefs was normally greeted with joy and various traditional songs, among which was Erukulele of Adode, Ado songs and others. Arrival is proclaimed amidst flying dust. This is a meeting definition of the joyous arrival of Ado songs and others, dust and sun flying to the air, given the new population of Ado villages and signed the nature of the entire terrain at that point in time. With the passage of time, this became part of the patronage of Ado people and it remains so to today. Roko, whose most important festival, was designed as official both the National Day and the new day in the front Ado Kingdom. The Ewe is the principal celebrant, while all other sons and daughters, the war chiefs, and others participate. The Iroko Festival is usually an occasion of happiness and merriment for Ado Kingdom. It shows that Ado-Ekiti, the kind of celebration of Ado Day, from its inception, a practice which later became popular and adopted by many towns in Nigeria, which now celebrate their respective days annually. Through the Uroko Festival, Ado people generally rejoice that another milestone is covered and reach their life's journey. They have simply scaled the past year over to renew. Not the entity is watching in the Uroko, and not adoration or secrecy, or secret society. It is a ritual-free festival dedicated on our historical, cultural, and traditional values in Ado-Ekiti. The Uroko festival attracts a great number of people, spectators from far and near in the past, to see or know His Royal Majesty, the Wind, who is in all things supreme and divine, and is rarely seen in public. He enters like this in ceremonial seclusion in his palace, and will appear to the people of his kingdom twice in a year. The first one is the Oitado, where we will appear in the public and will be propped by the Oitado. And the report of that is that there's nobody above the law. The second one is the Uroko Day. Traditions die hard, but the Uroko is still a crowd-pleasing festivity. The Uroko Day, the assembly of people under the Uroko tree include the following: Ado-Ekiti, the tournament military leaders of the Uroko Army, other military commanders and missionaries, emissaries from subordinate teams and teams, messengers carrying different gifts and food items from rulers of the wastewater villages, captured slaves, cultural masters, and displaced, etc. Then the process of the celebration itself. On the local day, after serving their people foods and drinks in their respective folds, the world is thereafter combined at the bathroom's lodge for entertainment, after which they all dance from there to the whisperers, the venue of the celebrations, drumming and singing war songs. Chipper from the head of the watches, that is the elements, comes last to the palace after elements must have arrived and all seated, dancing to Batato and traditional war songs. The greeting of the week take the form of traditional meetings and reunion of both. You can see the shoes at the beginning of the program. Take forward to greet the women that you are farming their oath, that they are still loyal to the kingdom. Then, the video. Okay, the first one appear in the wind concert led by the usual of Ado-Ekiti. Can see there battling with the traditional drums to come and pay homage. After that, traditional chiefs that we saw just 2 minutes ago, Ado-Ekiti is made up of 3 sectors. The okay wind, the Odo-Ado Okela, and then we come one after the other to play, to pay homage and reaffirm their loyalty to the throne. Then the Omawas, you can see the only man who was playing the other time, representing the Omawas in Ado-Ekiti. Their princes and princesses of the kingdom cut across the two really have to come forward. Then the Efa, Efa will come and reaffirm their loyalty too, repent and greet and pray for the will and the throne. Then the elections, the junior ones, that the watches, they will come forward, and finally the paraphon, their leader, will come, and you can notice one man will sit down, test all of them one after the other, to show whether they are still fit or proper to fight the war for the kingdom. If they are not split, then the Olorun we report and that we will decide otherwise. Then the queen will now speak on the throne, and we will tell the town all the happenings during the year, the challenge or challenges. We will tell the whole town the steady target for the new year. There we will announce to the whole town the challenge we have. And we use the Uroko festival to achieve many progress for Ado-Ekiti in about 28 years. Like the Faculty of Law at the research blast put up by Ado-Ekiti to acknowledge the Uroko festival, we organized that. The university was finally through the difficult situation, unable to accredit most of their courses. And so the visit came and we settled for the Faculty of Law, put up the Faculty of Law for them. I don't know whether we need to the Palace of Research from the Gate House to the innermost part of the Palace for this for 28 years. The effort you see here is as a result of the plan during the Uroko festival. But it's the Uroko day that we can gather all our sons and daughters to tell them the problem facing the town, and we'll be using that effectively, and it's helping us as expected. So Uroko is very, very important to our people. Then the non-indigenous and natives of our Uroko will come. The outside and the last, they all come and play their role and part to development of Ado-Ekiti. Then the day after the grand finale of the Uroko festival itself, we call it the Renu. Most people don't know what happened. We are telling the Uroko, the day the wind will speak, nobody will speak. The wind will just speak and the whole go. But in the following morning, as early as 6 o'clock, the paraffin will lead the water to the palace. All the ships will come. Then the paraffin will now analyze sentence by paragraph by paragraph the speech of the previous day with the wind. Then we will have any challenge. The paraffin will tell if there's any problem. We will change and we will take the decision. Step forward. What we need to do for the year. And the target for the year, so that another 12 months will come and report back. And there's only thing that is counting the day. You cannot say we celebrate in Uroko today, not in 8th of August this year, and it will be 20th of August next year. No. That the ship we charge with the local sugar, we'll be counting it every 5 days. So we know we cannot, it is not a thing that you can say August next year we celebrate in Uroko. No, it could be August, late August, or early September. So that ship will tell you when it's late, as soon as we celebrate Oitado. That's the day that people will come and see how I will flood the wind. Because it's that day that you know the date of Uroko. So the second day of Uroko. It's a regular celebration that takes place at the Oba Awamaro, that's the courtyard of royalty and dignity. Oba Awamaro is the most sacred place in Ado-Ekiti. You don't cause people there, you go there to pray. And people believe that whatever you have there, God will answer you. That is the practice from time immemorial, century, and it's so up to this man. And I pray it will be so forever.
Amen.
On the second day, the Iroko celebration takes place at the Owawa, that's called courtyard of royalty and dignity, within the palace earlier in the morning, when the paraffin, the head of the Iroko kingdom's watches, the elegant, gives a speech before the wind, who magnificently and royally sits on his traditional throne. The baton and all his elegant chiefs makes the speech a form of reappraising and discussion of the speech of the wind. All that happened in the previous year situated them when the context of the current happenings within the kingdom. After the paraffin speech, the wind usually gives a response in ways that can be likened to a speech from the throne. You will respond after the paraffin and the if there's any area we need to clear, we will tell them. Then everybody will go before the youth start to go to the farm. And that is why in the past, I know throughout the southwest, I don't think it's the dwell we have in New York, first place. And I'm a great man. I'm sure to see New York in America. Because after 28th of August now, 22nd, you have to go back to your farm. And clear your farm and start to work. Because I know this is an Iberian society. Iroko was a pure celebration of the history, culture, and tradition of Ado-Ekiti people, devoid of rituals, practices, and idolism. The Iroko festival in Ado-Ekiti is purely the celebration of the cultural essence of the people dating back to the establishment of Ado-Ekiti. It is a festival that has nothing to do with rituals, practices, and idolism. The first Igbo service is usually rotated annually between the various churches in Ado-Ekiti. Prior to the Iroko day, the way an Ado-Ekiti chief and Indians and where we shall have gone to the mosque for prayers regarding the Iroko festival. This aspect of the annual Iroko festival and the celebration, which starts and ends with prayers in the house of God, show that festival is not to teach by any standard that is not treated in secrecy. This is further put into perspective by the yearly publications of the minutes of meetings and all transactions on the Iroko festival by the planning committee in line with the nation that you can see the record. The past 8 years now you come to the palace, we can show you the record of each Iroko festival. Now, in conclusion, the foregoing education of the historical pedigree of the Iroko festival and the celebrations over the years in Ado-Ekiti is for the purpose of educating the general public. This is with a view to fostering its acceptability as one of the components that forms the tripod, history, culture, and tradition upon which the systemic existence of Ado-Ekiti people is predicated, and which has been so from time immemorial. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen of the press in particular, it is our hope that from now on, the Iroko festival will gain further international recognition that will propel the internet cultural peers in other kingdoms, at least within and outside Nigeria. I thank you all.
Es que la dimensión